All right, I'm back. Sorry about that. Is this a new one or this a bug? Like, did I finish C and B?
I've been thinking.
Oh, okay, this is new. Okay, that went dark in the end there, but sure. Alright, Ingrid, I think you got two with Ingrid. B and A.
Seriously, you don't have to sound that impressed. With school suspended and the war raging, we've all had to adapt to changing circumstances. Felix and Dimitri both succeeded their fathers. They're now burning the candle at both ends, right? I can't go around causing trouble with unending scandals when I'm supposed to be the mature one of the bunch.
You are?
It is wonderful to see you turn a new leaf.
You're the mature one? What?
I told you to stop sounding so impressed. I suppose I had this coming.
I am sorry, Sylvain. I was only teasing. Think of it as payback for everything you put me through. Still, not having to clean up after you has been a real weight lifted from my shoulders.
Yeah, I was a handful in my wild days. But looking back, I really appreciate everything you did for me.
In that case, you should make the change permanent so you never cause trouble for anyone again. Though, honestly, I do not really know what to do with myself now that I am not spending all my time apologizing for you. Frankly, I was convinced you were useless without me.
Sorry. Again.
Please, no. You gave me experience I'd never have gotten otherwise. If I were truly miserable, I would have abandoned you to the wolves long ago. Besides, it wasn't all bad. You were the one who finally coaxed me from my room after Glenn's death, remember?
Okay, I'm confused. Do you want me to go back to being a huge flirt, or...?
Don't be ridiculous.
Yeah, figured.
As you said, we have all had to adapt to changing circumstances, which means we cannot cling to the past forever. You and I are no exception. It is merely a touch sad to come to the realization.
Oh yeah, there is another one. Okay.
Instead of immediately disparaging the giver?
Maybe you're right. In that case, I accept. I reached a good stopping point anyway, so I may as well eat on your coin. Phew. It has been some time since I've eaten this much. I've been so busy lately, my meals have consisted of whatever quick snack I can scrounge up in the moment.
Oh, that makes the incredibly hefty bill worth it. Also, it's been a while since I've been able to watch you eat. I think I kinda missed it.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Sorry, that came out all wrong. What I meant to say was that it's a relief to finally see you enjoy a decent meal. I mean, basically family, you know? And I'm sure Felix and Dimitri would feel the same way.
Is that so?
When we were talking earlier, you said something about how a person can't cling to the past forever. Well, I think that's why it makes us so happy when we realize some things never change.
Some things never change, huh? Hold on. That means you were still gawking at me as I ate.
Yeah, but can you blame me? You are a fascinating eater. I mean, you're normally really serious, but when you eat, it's like your entire face lights up.
Do you even hear yourself? Yes, well, speaking of things that never change, I thought of an even more important one.
What's that?
Our friendship. The way we're there for each other through thick and thin. Even if our relationship changes, we will always hold each other dear.
Okay, that line is way too cheesy. Who taught you to say that? What rogues have you been hanging out with?
Stop complaining and come with me. I want to buy some treats for everyone.
I follow you to the ends of the earth, my lady.
Alright. Almost done. We got like 3 or 4 left. Next is, alright, we got 3 more.
Back to grab it.
What a coincidence. I was also headed to the mess hall to look for something. Oh, yay! Then we can go together. Seriously, it feels so much better if you were with me. Not entirely sure why that's the case, but okay. Oh gosh, it's so dark. From the grass over there. Probably just another night owl. I wonder if it's... Annette, stop! You're going to run into that pile of... Ow! Who put these crates here? Crates. Oh, Annette. Well, that was quite the ordeal, but we finally made it. Thanks, Ingrid. I'm glad nobody got hurt, aside from you and those crates. But if I may, Annette, are you afraid of the dark? Yeah, actually. I've been afraid of it my whole life. I'd give anything not to be, but I just can't seem to shake it. What about you, Ingrid? Aren't you scared? I mean, a ghost could pop out of anywhere and ghost you.
Ghost you?
The dark does not really bother me, no. As I've never seen a ghost, I'm not afraid of them. But doesn't it scare you to think about it? I mean, just imagine some icky dead person rising from the earth and coming at you with big, chattery teeth. Certainly, we had such stories back home in Galatea. My brothers loved to tell them when I was a child. But if they were true, we would not be able to walk to breakfast without bumping into a horde of the dead. Huh. Yeah, I suppose that's true. But it's still hard to get the idea out of my head. I personally think it would be wonderful if the dead became ghosts and we could see them again. But when people die, that's it. We can't see or speak to them ever again. Yeah. When someone dies, they're gone forever. But that's all the more reason to treasure what little time we get, right? Agree. We have only one life to live, after all. In that case, I'm gonna walk back all by myself. Are you sure? We went through quite the struggle just to make it here. If I want to conquer my fears, I'd better do it while I'm alive. The dark is still pretty terrifying, but I'm gonna push through it. I could learn a thing or two from her optimism. We only live once.
Alright, two more. Dorothy and Petra.
Over land or property, because it is already belonging to all.
sounds wonderful, Petra. We are only squabbling over who is sitting on the throne. Oh, and lovers.
Oh, so that's where things get messy.
Juicy.
Hi, ladies. Ain't safe for a couple of prim skirts to be out here alone. Why don't you come with us?
They will murder you.
Not interested.
I mean, Petra will. Yep.
Watch out, Dorothea. This one has skill.
Do they? Is he using magic?
That was incredibly uncivil of them. Are you all right? You aren't hurt, are you? I am well. And you? Not a scratch. I'm so relieved those brutes didn't mess up that silky face of yours. But I am not wearing silk upon my face, Dorothea. No, I'm talking about your skin. It's lustrous and smooth, you know? This is a strange comparison. Silk is easily damaged. My skin has strength. Here, feel. That's all right. I can tell just by looking. Then you are knowing that my skin is like steel, not like silk. I am thinking we should be taking more care from now on. You are precious to me. I do not want to be losing you to thugs. One of them was a capable fighter. Please take my apologies for placing you in such danger. If anyone is trying such a thing again, I will be keeping you safe. Hey, you're special to me too, you know. And no one's gonna lay a finger on your head while I'm around.
Alright. Lost one. The one I don't care about is set this on flame. Alright. Okay, they only have one support. Sure.
Flame, it has come to my attention that you have gone out and aided the Knights of Seros again. I heard that you made your way to the infirmary and spent the entire day treating the sick and wounded. What in the world were you thinking? Do you not know how dangerous that was?
I am sorry, brother. However, the Knights very much appreciated my assistance.
Their appreciation is inconsequential. Your own safety should be your only concern. This is exactly what happened during that fated battle. You exhausted your strength healing those who were injured.
Yes, I remember. No matter how many people I helped, the number of wounded only increased.
You were so young. Your body must have been crying out for you to stop, and yet you refused. And now you are left with a body that demands extended periods of slumber. You have not forgotten, have you?
Of course not.
If you do not exercise extreme caution, you may not wake up for such a thing to happen again.
I am well aware. Every night I lie awake, afraid that my eyes will not open come morning. But if I let fear control me and begrudge my power, there will be no reprieve for those who suffer. The thought of that is too much to bear. Furthermore, if we lose this war...
Flame. Should that come to pass, I will protect you. No matter the cost. I swear upon my wife. Your mother.
Father, I have been wondering something. Is it truly so difficult for the people of Falkland to live in peace? The world would be a much happier place if everyone could live in harmony with each other.
I know. I feel the same. But so do the majority of those risking their lives in this war. That is why I believe a peaceful future awaits us, beyond this dreadful conflict. That is the reason I fight. And so you do not have to.
Father,
I lost you, I would lose the very meaning of my life. And so we will always be together.
Come now, Father. Please try to understand that I cannot stay with you forever. I will grow up eventually. Though I do promise to refrain from any unnecessary recklessness. And until that day comes, I will always be with you. Besides which, I am certain Mother would be cross with me if I left you all alone.
I understand. Thank you, Flynn.
All right. That was the last one. Finally, we're done. Alright. And that took a while, wasn't it? Extra Lord Pullian.